to Worldwide News. In studio, I am Anitin Kanani. Today's news are: fires in coastal France, storm brings wind, rain to Midwest South, Permian Lake in Iran is drying up, blue wave turned red with blood after shark attack, gay student in alleged work camp living commit suicide, the potential health benefits and drawbacks of coffee. Now in details. 7 people have been killed in a fire at a hostel housing immigrants in France. 4 others were seriously injured in the blaze, which quickly spread from outside Arabic into the main stairwell of the 9-story building in Dijon. Some jumped from the windows in a desperate bid to reach safety. More than 140 people were inside the hostel when the fire broke out overnight. Dozens of men, women, and children who have been given temporary shelter as an investigation into the blaze gets underway.
7 people have been killed in a fire at a hostel housing immigrants in France. 4 others were seriously injured in the blaze, which quickly spread from an outside rubbish bin to the main stairwell of the 9-story building in Dijon. Thick smoke hindered residents' efforts to escape. Some jumped from windows in a desperate bid to reach safety.
Permian Lake in northwestern Iran is drying up. One of the biggest saltwater lakes in the world and the registered UNESCO reserve, it is home to hundreds of species of birds and reptiles and mammals. But experts say a combination of drought and the construction of dams on rivers feeding the lake has contributed to the drying up. The Lake Urmia in Iran's West Azerbaijan province has turned red as the result of an environmental phenomenon known as the red tide. Soft-like foam substance produced by algae started to redden Urmia from the East Azerbaijan coast and gradually covered the whole lake. The red tide is actually the result of an algal bloom, an event in which marine or freshwater algae accumulate rapidly in the water. The effect of excessive algae on fish can be lethal. It produces oxygen radicals which can damage fish gills, possibly leading to suffocation. Some environmentalists say the phenomenon is caused by nutrient loading from human activities or industrial and city wastewater, which include nitrate and phosphate.